Power is still out for thousands of Iowans. An ice storm early Wednesday snapped power poles and trees. Officials tell us electricity might not be back on there for 3 to 7 days. One of the biggest problems is getting to rural roads, which are still icy. KATV Newswatch 7's Marla Raby is live in Walnut, Iowa, which is in Cass County, with the latest. Marla?
Yeah, Brandy, here in Walnut, Iowa, you're going to see a lot of this dangling trees coated in a thick layer of ice. Over in Atlantic, Iowa, where we spent much of our afternoon, it's a lot of the same scenery. Only there, that ice is bringing down an enormous amount of trees and power lines, leaving many in the dark. Take a trip down any Atlantic Iowa street. This is what you'll see.
It's kind of like a war zone because, you know, you can hear the limbs falling and the big crack and then the whoosh because the ice hits.
It's just been crazy. It's just been scary just hearing the trees snap and been scary.
Broken branches in every yard, on every roof, nearly everywhere you look.
There's a lot of old maple trees down in that area and their branches just... You hear them pop and bang and fall, and you hope, oh, I hope that doesn't come through our roof.
Those falling branches have knocked out power to a good part of the community. Here you see one power line dangling over a driveway. The Nishna Valley YMCA is open as a warming station for those left in the cold.
Lines are down from our house to the main line, and there's a lot of damage down in there. I don't know for sure what will happen, but we'll be fine. There aren't any broken windows and just one little strip of siding's off, so we're very lucky.
There's still a lot of work left to do in Atlantic, so it's hard to say when all the power will finally be restored. Until then, they're making the most of where this wicked winter weather has left them.
I think we slept about as well as we've ever because of the coldness. It was just like in a cabin somewhere.
Now, the Cass County Emergency Manager does say that they hope to get some of that power restored today, but as you know, it is a complicated process with all those down limbs. Now, at the YMCA, they did have about 10 people stay overnight there last night and are expecting to have about that again tonight. Reporting live in Walnut, Iowa, Marla Raby, KET.